Hey, what is up, Design Nation? In this session, you're going to learn how to use layer masking in Photoshop so that we can create something like this. The first thing that I want to do is make sure that the foreground of my image is set to black, and then choose the paint bucket tool, make sure my layer is selected, and then paint it. And then I'm going to skinny things up with the crop tool, so that I don't have such a weird shape of things. Select text, and I'm going to have to make two columns of text. Select it and make sure that it's white. Photoshop currently doesn't allow you to make more than one column. They probably want you to use InDesign, so we're just going to have to do this. 90, using two different columns. And that looks pretty good. So I have two vector text layers for each column. And the next thing I want to do is go to Open, and I'm going to select. I have eight different years. I'm just going to do two images. You'll get the gist of it. So I'm just going to choose four. So I'm going to hold Shift and select these four images, open. And so it opens all of them. I'm going to select this first one, hit Control A for select all, and Control C for copy. Come over to the text here, hit Control V for paste, Control T for transform. Select this corner and hold Shift so that it scales uniformly. If you don't hold Shift, then you're going to get this. So hold Shift, select so that it roughly covers this area, hit Enter so that it stays there, and then for this you want to come to Layer and go down to Create Clipping Mask. From now on, after this, I'm going to hit Alt plus Control plus G to do this, so I don't have to come here every time I want to do that. So it selects it, and you can see that nothing happened because actually this text here is on the right side. So if I select this image and move it over, then you'll be able to see it here. I can move this text and it stays the same. So I'm choosing this, Control A, Control C, paste. If for some reason I had this selected, you'll see that this comes outside. All you have to do is drag that below the image, the other clipped image, and you're good to go. Just adjust that manually, and then Control T to transform it to the right size. Control A, and I'm going to select this text so that it goes above that. For the other side, you're going to have to make another clipping mask for this text, so you're going to have to manually do that. So I did the Control-Alt-G there as well. Just select this text, or select the image, put it there. And we have one more. And then I want this to be on top so that it shows through. And there we go. We have something that is very similar to this image. And what's nice about doing it this way is that you can edit it, you can add in images and change them as needed. So I hope this helped. If you thought it was useful, please share it with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.